R2! Moriban, we must go!
There's two Yodas! What's going on?
Yeah.
That was great to have an arc of him. Well, it's still going on, of course, but... So this one's called Sacrifice. It's the finale of season 6.
Oh, wow.
One more left. This is going to be intense.
Right.
Yeah, I mean, I love having Yoda as a focus, and what a challenge for him to learn immortality and through those priestesses as well. Like, that was so eerie and freaky, like,
wasn't
all the different
it?
Emotions that they had, and they weren't, like, a solid entity at all. They were part of the Force already, like, full on.
Yeah, yes, and they had to be together, and he had to learn a lot about himself.
Mm-hmm.
He sure did.
Yeah, so now he's going to Moriban.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
Ancient and Sith planet or something, right? So,
yeah, right.
What's going to be there? Ancient secrets of something. Maybe there's civilization still there.
A lot of darkness he might have to conquer. Maybe it'll try to bring some darkness in from him out.
Mm-hmm.
You don't know, and try to, you know, have some challenges of his own that he has to conquer.
I mean, even on this past planet, him fighting or battling mentally, like that shadow Yoda.
Dark shadow? Yes.
Mm-hmm.
Like, that was very scary.
Wasn't it?
And to have that challenge there.
Yeah.
I mean, I can't imagine what Moriban's going to be like.
Yeah. R2's going to do a lot of, like,
Oh, I know, because he was having to leave that planet, and now it's like, ooh, Moriban, we must go.
Oh, no.
So, we know later on Yoda does, of course, succeed in learning how to be immortal.
That's right. Well, he's going to have to go through some things beforehand.
That's for sure, yeah.
R2's upside down.
I know, I was like, oh no!
R2!
Are you foreshadowing what's going to happen in this episode?
Yeah, right?
No!
Oh,
no!
No! Yeah. I need to get my cutouts. Where are mine?
That's
and
right.
Mom's ready, too. They? She's geared up with her helmet.
And then
and C-3PO.
Lurking in the background.
Ooh! I feel left out now.
Hi,
I do
guys.
Have Yoda, and I do have Obi-Wan with me. And the Darksaber. So, shall we get into this last episode?
Yes.
Yes, we will.
All right. So, 6:13. For you from yourself. Yeah, so this is going to be a big challenge.
I guess so.
He finds 5 priestesses who will teach him how to manifest consciousness after death.
Yeah, it was creepy.
Careful, we must be. Deserted this planet.
It's already money.
Long ago.
Again, leave you I must, my friend. Guard the ship, you will.
Yeah, I'm like, I'm with you, R2. Oh, no.
I don't want to be by myself.
Just to know that there's that much risk. He's like, if I don't come back in 3 nights. Love the music always, you know. Yeah. Ooh, just like a big centipede thing.
Afraid of you. I am not.
We shall see.
Oh, a lot of them.
Surrounding you.
They will know you are here. We will tell them. You will die and be nothing.
Huh.
Tell Lord Sidious I am on my way.
Do you know who I am?
Yes.
Shredder.
The Sith killed each other, but from the ashes of destruction, I was the last survivor. Have you come to be my apprentice? You must kill me to gain my place.
Dead, you are.
You do not fear me.
Okay, good.
Awesome.
I sense we have a great opportunity, but we must act swiftly.
Inside, there is a place where we have no control, for it is a place of absolute darkness. Be careful, for what they may offer will certainly feel like an answer.
Only the presence of someone significant to you would allow you to sense this ripple through time and space. We shall, however, use the strong bond that once existed between you and your master to allow us to see things. Hold out your hand, apprentice.
Stab, slice, and a finger.
Just in the Jedi. Concentrate on Master Yoda. We shall come to him with a familiar face. A long lost face.
Oh, he's so gonna be so evil and creepy. Man, so this is gonna be the ultimate test too, because now he's gonna have a connection with them.
Sifo Dyas, help me, please.
It's not real,
Yoda.
Right?
No.
I have been imprisoned. Free me, and I will reveal it.
No!
He knows how to achieve what you seek. Gain the power you deserve. And save the future.
No.
Ooh.
Sidious.
So close.
Oh.
Gonna pass out?
Man.
What are your orders?
Orders?
Are you all right, Master?
What is happening here?
A rogue shuttle slipped through the security grid. We suspect Dooku was on board. We believe he is meeting with his master, the Sith Lord.
Feel their power.
Your orders, Master.
Execute them, we must. End it now. We will. Move in.
I've got two confirmed targets. Be ready for additional unfriendlies.
It appears we have company.
Right in a row, just like that.
You cannot stop what is to come.
Yep. Because that's what happens. I love Yoda so much.
And the giant bridge.
Yeah, freaking bridge again. Whew. He's so fast. Bridges, Kim.
Let him die, and you can stop all that I will do.
Ooh. Boomerang. Yep, sacrificing himself too. Just take off his robe and use it as a parachute. Can't see his face. Ew, how creepy is that? He doesn't have a head.
We have failed. We will need more time. if we are to defeat him.
Died, have I?
In a way, the one you know as Qui-Gon Jinn will commune with you and guide your training. There is another. Skywalker.
Aw. Oh, hear the baby crying, then you hear the breathing of Anakin.
The Council has assembled.
Afraid. Not much there is to say of my journey. Already lost, we have. Yet, open to us, a path remains. Victory. For all time.
Like, give us more, give us more.
I know. He's so wise, we can't say much. Man, even how they ended that was different. It was like a very smooth transition to the credits, you know?
Yes,
so now it's really becoming real, you know? It's making you really think, like, bad things are coming down or happening soon.
Right, it's inevitable.
Even the music at the end.
Mm-hmm.
It's like more
sad. Extremely different.
Ooh, yeah. Like, it's connecting a lot more with the movies, I feel like. And what a test to go through.
That's right, yeah.
That was incredible. And he was too strong.
That's great. We know he's so strong, but to see that is, like, amazing. I mean, it really was incredible to see that. And Sidious being there, actually connecting and being part of that vision.
That's right.
To test him.
Yoda couldn't see his face, neither.
That was creepy, too, because we know that he doesn't figure it out because it's too late at that point. But, like, he's so close, and then there's no head. Like, just so freaky.
It is. It's incredible that he can't connect it, you know? It's just amazing how he just can't, you know? We understand that he can't, but to us, it's like, come on! Make no connection, but...
And the characters are very stylized in this. I mean, of course, Sidious, we've seen him in the movies, and he's very evil-looking, but he can change his appearance a bit, too,
yes,
where even though he has, like, the same ugly chin, like the super wrinkly chin, he looks even more evil and demonic when he is his true self. But then when he's Palpatine, he looks a little bit more gentle, you know?
Yeah.
Not just his mannerisms, but his face doesn't look as... Maybe it's because he's not grimacing or something.
Like rigid.
And I believe that we see more than they do, because Yoda even said something like, finally we meet. So he saw him in a vision, and it was super dark there, so we probably saw more than Yoda actually did, so he doesn't actually see the face or anything. But yeah, like, you would hope that the Force, like, he'd be able to know who that was, because he's so close to Palpatine that he's right in front of you, but yet, you know, so close, but yet so far.
Yeah.
He's just that strong, and they just don't think it's that close.
Yeah, and you'd think, like, when he is Palpatine, you would think that all these Jedi, at the very least Yoda, can feel some darkness from him. Mm-hmm. But he can't. He hides it so well. He's such a master at it.
He is. I mean, they know something's going on there, but not that close. So it's just terrible that we know. We just want to help out. And I just noticed, because we are on season 7 next, that the next episode's called The Bad Batch. So that's a new series that came out.
That's kind of fun to hear the name of the new series.
So that'll be fun. So most of you do know that after the Clone Wars, we are going to watch Rebels, but The Bad Batch just came out, and we have a ton of requests for that. So we're going to watch that after the Clone Wars, because it takes place afterwards anyways. So
maybe we'll get, like, a little introduction of it.
Yeah, so I'm guessing that the characters in this next episode will be part of The Bad Batch. I love how it's titled the same. What should be something completely different?
Yeah, right.
But, that's right.
Yeah, so that's kind of cool to see that. But loved this arc with Yoda. I mean, to see him go through those struggles. Again, I really wanted to see more with his home planet, with his species, and have a challenge there. But it wasn't about that. So him having a connection still with Dooku, that was interesting as well.
Right,
because even though there's so much hate and they're divided now, like, he still had a bond with him, a close bond at one point.
Yeah.
So what did that make you think of when you think of Dooku and Yoda once being chummy together, once being, like, master and apprentice? Like,
to me, it makes me feel, how did he break away? It's almost like Anakin and Obi, you know, it's just, we know what happens, and you just see that he broke away. He wanted something more. Dooku wanted something more. He wanted to be stronger, and he didn't care if it was darker. Mm-hmm. And, you know, he thought he was succeeding so well, and he thought he can conquer Yoda, but...
Mm-hmm. Yeah, I'm glad Yoda's strong, but during that scene, like, it just made me feel really sad, like, just to be reminded that they were close at one point, and
right.
he just got so corrupt by the dark side and just wanted something very different, and it made me really think of Obi-Wan as well, Obi and Anakin, but it just went right to Ahsoka with me, because we haven't seen any mm-hmm. of that happen yet.
That's right, yeah.
So Anakin, like, I really enjoy his character in this series, and to know that he goes that dark, he kills
yeah.
children, he kills millions of people, he killed, I mean, billions, I mean, he destroyed planets too, like, he
That's
becomes
right, yeah.
the most evil person in the galaxy, and to be mm-hmm. this caring person right now, like,
yeah,
he's so
yeah.
different.
That's
and
awesome.
I know
you're so right, and I'm sure Dooku was the same way at one point,
probably.
Yeah, like, they were normal, good people. Not that you had to be normal, mm-hmm. but you know what I mean, like, they were
yeah.
caring, compassionate yeah. people, and they turned into these evil dark lords. I mean,
right.
it really just made me go,
scary.
Man, that's gonna really suck, to put it lightly.
God,
but I just thought of Ahsoka there too, and Obi. Like, I love all those characters so much, and to
mm-hmm.
see that no one's perfect, and things can happen to really change a person.
Definitely.
So that
that's
really
right.
just made me think of all the different relationships we see, and it doesn't mean people are truly good. Like, they can turn and go bad. To the point where you don't even realize there's, like, a bond there, that there was ever a connection in the first place. Like, wow, no, there was one at one point. So just to be reminded of that, like, yeah, Dooku was under Yoda's wing at one point. Like, he
mm-hmm.
was his Padawan. Like,
yeah.
that's insane
yeah.
to think that way.
And through that relationship and the change with Dooku, he sees a little touch with Anakin, how he oversaw some maneuvers and some missions because he saw Anakin using his emotions, his feelings to make a plan or to
mm-hmm.
have an idea to do something with a mission. He knew that he had too much emotion at times. And I think it's because he knows that you can change from a Jedi to a Sith Lord, you know,
mm-hmm.
and
That's true, yeah.
he was very cautious of that. And he knows Anakin is also a wonderful Jedi. On top of it, so he's very strong with the Force, but
yeah,
it was interesting to see that. Yeah,
and it's a vision again, but still, like, being tested, it's so real, and him trying to protect Anakin, and when Sidious saying, like, you can end it all right now, just let him die.
Yeah, that's,
you know?
So true,
like,
right?
That was crazy, because
yes.
I'm like, yeah, that's kind of foreshadowing a lot, hint, hint, that
right.
something,
yes.
I mean, like, you don't want Anakin to die, though, because, like, he is a good person, but he dies technically and becomes Darth Vader.
Darth Vader,
but
yeah.
if he did end it there, it probably would have been very different, you know? I mean, that was a vision, but I'm just saying, like,
mm-hmm.
we talked about that in other scenarios with Anakin surviving something. So it just really hit hard where I was like, wow, you know, there's just so many things that
yeah.
could have prevented this. But as a whole, like, things had to happen to come full circle with Skywalker, with Luke Skywalker actually becoming the light that balances the Force when he kills his father, you know.
Yes.
Mm-hmm.
But yeah, so to even mention the other Skywalker, and you hear the baby crying.
Oh yeah.
Yeah, that's, you know, and it's just so sad because Yoda's seeing what's going to happen. It's already solidified what's going to happen, and he can't say anything to Mace, he can't say anything to Obi,
mm-hmm.
and he's just allowing it. Because it has to go through this process, because he knows that not through the Clone Wars, but through another avenue, there will be light eventually.
Yeah.
So
he's
it's
so
really
wise.
Intense, man.
Wow,
and with
is.
Everything that he went through too, like, he can't say much about that, because only a few people have this privilege to learn how to have immortality. So he knows
mm-hmm.
that, he respects that, so he can't really tell them much because they're going to get too curious about it.
Mm-hmm.
You know, so he is the chosen one to continue on with the Force, as we know.
Yeah.
But man, to actually not be able to tell anyone close to you,
because
you can alter the future. I mean, it sucks anyways soon, like how bad it's going to get. But, you know, he just can't say anything. So, yeah, that's hard. I can't imagine being like that. So that makes him a very strong person just for that reason, too.
And he's so wise. He knows it's for the overall good. that he has to do this.
Yeah. You know, one good thing that I always love about Yoda is he looks so frail. Like, he's this wise old man, right? And he has his cane. And even watching him in the back, and it was still a vision, but it was still him physically in the vision or whatever.
Don't
and he's, like, going with his cane and, you know, walking slow. But then when he went to go fight Sidious, he was, like, full on, like, flipping all over the place. Like the
he was. It was a really good sequence there. Yeah.
And it's always on a bridge, guys. That's always our joke.
I know.
Bridge,
yes. And I always have to say
those
that.
Those are the best scenes, though. They really are. I mean, like, well-established. You have different levels to fight on. There's more danger there. And
yeah, and even when Sidious went off the bridge, he came back with his...
That's right, Jed. He was
good. Opening up the floor and the bridge and...
Makes it even more lethal. Yeah, we have like different landscapes, so like lava underneath you, which is everything's so dangerous. And yeah, so that was a really good battle. So good episode. Yeah, I'm glad Yoda actually accomplished what he wanted, and we knew he was going to because of the movies. And he's amazing. He really is. Ooh, but just to be that close to Sidious and how they're aware because he's on the planet and it's so... just like with the evil, it just so like
it was, and it was perfectly orchestrated where he had to get Dooku and they had to connect with Yoda through the vision to have this whole thing plan out. I mean, that's why he said to Dooku, you have to come immediately, you know, you're summoned to come see me immediately.
Yeah, and Yoda didn't expect that was actually Sidious for real. Like, maybe he did, but maybe he just thought it was a vision that he was getting tested. Mm-hmm. Because even Dooku questioned that, right? He's like, won't he be able to detect us or something? And so it's just impressive. I mean, like, heck, you have, again, Palpatine that close. I keep going back and forth his name.
Right.
You know what I mean?
Close.
Like, the Chancellor's so close to him, and you have Sidious right there, and yet he still doesn't know. Like, he knows, you know, around him there's something corrupt going on, but he doesn't know how close it is and how deep it goes.
Right. Wow.
Crazy. So very good episode, guys. Thank you so much for watching. I can't wait for the next episode, The Bad Batch. I'm just so excited to watch that and see what it's about.
I am too. This is
so please
be
no
great.
Spoilers. Yes.
Yes.
So thank you guys. Until next time. See you later. Bye.
Bye.
May the Force
subscribe
be with you.
You must before we go to Bad Batch.
Please do.
Thank you.